blood pressure, or simply BP, measures the force of circulating blood against the artery walls. Usually it expresses a ratio of systolic blood pressure, which measures BP at its highest point during heartbeats, and diastolic blood pressure, which measures BP at its lowest point between heartbeats. And it's measured in millimeters of mercury, or mmHg. The blood pressure 120 over 80 or below is considered normal. If it's higher than 120 over 80, then you run the risk of falling victim to the silent killer, or hypertension, or simply high blood pressure. According to the CDC, this condition affects about 108 million US adults. That's roughly 45% of the population. My guess is that it's a similar percentage globally. It has no visible symptoms, and only about 1 in 4 of those with the condition actually have it under control. In fact, it can be even fatal. People with blood pressure 180 or 120 and higher have an 80% chance of death within 1 year. And the average survival rate for people with such high blood pressure is only 10 months. So, why is it so bad to have high blood pressure? Let's talk about that. Coming up. Hi, Andre here. Welcome to the Practical Health Channel. The human body contains around 5 liters of blood, constantly circulating by the heart. With every contraction, the heart creates pressure, forcing the blood through a network of vessels almost 160,000 kilometers long. 120 over 80 blood pressure is considered normal. But if either systolic blood pressure is above 120 or diastolic blood pressure is above 80, blood pressure is considered elevated or high, and the risk of negative health effects increases. Several different categories exist that classify blood pressure. Elevated blood pressure is when the systolic BP ranges from 120 to 129 and diastolic BP of less than 80. And if the blood pressure is above 130 over 80, it's high blood pressure. Finally, when the blood pressure readings are 180 or 120 or high, it's a hypertensive crisis. This is when it's really dangerous. When blood pressure remains above normal levels for extended period of time, two negative developments happen in the body. Number one is that our blood vessels get stronger to compensate for an extra pressure against their walls. And number two is that the heart must work overtime to circulate blood through the body. Two supercritical things that lead to many problems in the body. Let's talk about each of these developments and start with the blood vessels. To compensate for the strain caused by hypertension, our body strengthens the blood vessels so they can handle increased pressure. It causes the blood vessels' walls to become thick. Makes sense, right? This contributes to the development of atherosclerosis, or the hardening of the arteries. Atherosclerosis then causes the development of hard substance called plaque, which often goes unnoticed until it either ruptures or becomes severe enough to block blood flow through the arteries. By the way, the diameter of our biggest artery, aorta, is about 25 millimeters, like that. But the diameter of small arteries, or arteriolas, ranges from 0.01 millimeters to 1 millimeter. And the capillaries are about 8 to 10 microns in diameter, just enough to pass through a red blood cell of about 7.5 to 8.5 microns in diameter. As you can see, there is not that much space in our blood vessels to accumulate plaque, right? Another thing that happens when our blood vessels constantly operate under high blood pressure is that they become weakened and easily ruptured. So a sac of blood can be created in those ruptures, and it's called aneurysm. If this blood bag bursts, it's called a hemorrhage. Both plaque ruptures and hemorrhages can lead to serious health outcomes. When they occur in the brain, they can cause a stroke. In the kidneys, they can lead to kidney disease or even kidney failure. In the eyes, they can lead to retinopathy or even vision loss. If all of those were not bad enough, they can lead to sexual dysfunction as well. So that's how blood vessels are affected. But how does hypertension affect the heart itself? Normal heart rates is usually between 60 and 100 beats per minute. And the heart moves about 7,500 liters of blood through the body every day. That's more than 200 million liters of blood in a lifetime. But when blood pressure is high, the heart develops left ventricular hypertrophy, which is basically the development of a stronger left ventricle. You might ask, what's wrong with the stronger left ventricle? Well, this stronger left ventricle now needs more oxygen. but during hypertrophy, no new blood vessels are grown to compensate for the increase in size. The result is that oxygen can't be distributed to the right places in the heart at the right times, and some muscles become oxygen deprived. This can lead to a myocardial infarction or simply a heart attack, or even to heart failure in the event that the left ventricle can't generate sufficient blood pressure. So, this is what happens in our body when we have high blood pressure. Bad things. So, clearly, hypertension can cause some pretty serious problems. So, let's talk about what causes high blood pressure and how we can fix it. Primary hypertension, which has no apparent cause, has several contributing factors such as age, extra weight, high salt diet, drinking, smoking, low activity level, and many others, including genetics. We don't know them all. About 90% of all hypertension cases can be attributed to the sum combination of the factors on this list. Besides that, there is secondary hypertension, which has an underlying cause. This can be diabetes, polycystic kidney disease, renal vascular hypertension, Cushing's syndrome, adrenal problems, thyroid problems, and others. So, as you can see, there are a lot of causes of hypertension. Unfortunately, hypertension has no cure, only treatment. Sorry. So, what changes can be made to reduce the risk of hypertension? There are several of them, and many people see results in as little as 3 days after implementing them. Number one is smoking. If you smoke, you should know that smoking possesses major risk for cardiovascular health. Nicotine acts as a vasopressor, meaning it causes blood vessels to contract and blood pressure to rise. It damages the kidneys, increases visceral fat levels, and leads to increased insulin resistance. It also releases catecholamines like dopamine and epinephrine, leading to the arterial rigidity. Quitting smoking has been clinically proven to reduce BP in a short time. So, reducing nicotine intake or eliminating it from your routine altogether will do wonders for your blood pressure and cardio health. Next, consider adopting a healthy diet like DASH. Also, consider increasing your uptake in polyunsaturated fats and omega-3. Another lever is reducing your salt intake. If you can keep your salt consumption below 6 grams per day, you may see a reduction in blood pressure of 2 to 8 millimeters of mercury. Normal blood pressure can also be supported with healthy weight loss and regular exercise. Just 30 minutes of physical activity per day, 5 times per week, leads to a decrease in pressure of 4 to 9 millimeters of mercury. And every 5.1 kilograms of weight lost determines a decrease in blood pressure of 4.4 and 3.6 millimeters of mercury in normal and hypertensive patients respectively. Here's an interesting fact. For every kilogram of fat within the body, we need 3.5 kilometers of extra blood vessels to support healthy circulation, which is clearly a lot of distance for blood to cover, that results in blood pressure increase. Finally, alcohol consumption. Man can consume 20 to 30 grams of ethanol per day without significantly affecting blood pressure, and women can consume 10 to 20. It can be difficult to calculate the exact amount of ethanol in different drinks due to differences in their strength, but if we assume that one alcoholic beverage contains about 14 grams of pure alcohol, then this translates to about 1 or 2 drinks per day, depending on their strength. Respecting this limit alone could result in blood pressure decrease of 2 to 4 millimeters of mercury. So there you have it. Maintaining healthy blood pressure is critical to living a healthy life. And letting it get out of control can lead to serious consequences or even death from organ failure. As we discussed, the list of factors which contribute to hypertension is long, and this might make it intimidating to address this issue on a personal level. Changing all habits can be tough. But luckily, the number of things that we can do to manage our BP and avoid hypertension in the first place are equally numerous. So a compatible solution exists for people of any lifestyle. If you have the willpower to implement all of these changes, you could even see a reduction in blood pressure ranging from 15 to 30 millimeters of mercury. So, good luck! And that's all for today. As you work to manage your blood pressure in the future, I hope you'll think of our channel. After all, hypertension is an issue very close to our hearts and blood vessels. So, stay strong, stay healthy, and see you next time. Bye! We'll be right back.